Hello everyone and welcome to class of Elastic Block Store. So today in this class we will continue with its volume types. So EBS volume types. We have two types of volumes or elastic block store: solid state drives and hard disk drives. A solid state device, SSD, is basically a solid state storage device that uses integrated circuit which assembles as memory to store data persistently. SSD technology uses electronic interfaces which are compatible with block input-output HDDs, and it permits simple replacements in common applications. Whereas a hard disk drive, HDD, it is a data storage device and it uses magnetic storage to store and retrieve digital information. Here, data is accessed in random access manner, meaning that individual blocks of data can be stored and retrieved in any order, not only sequentially. That means we are having two types of volume types: solid state drives and hard disk drives. So let's discuss about how to create a EBS volume. Now this is the region, like we have to select the region. First of all, what we need to do, we have to create a EBS volume. So we require to open AWS management console. We have to log into the management console. After that, we require to check the region where we require to create a volume. We require to choose a volume, Elastic Block Store, and then we have to create a volume. So in a create a volume, we have to choose the type of the volume that we require to choose. Like we have discussed about general purpose SSDs, provisioned IOPS SSDs, IO1, or throughput optimized SSD. So this is how to create. In our practical classes, we will discuss how to create EBS volume. Now how we can attach an EBS volume to an instance. Like we require to attach our volume or storage to an instance. Again, log into console, open console. We have to go to the volumes, select volume, and then attach volume. So in an instance, if our instance is running, we can attach our volume to a particular instance. Then we have EBS optimized instances. An Amazon EBS optimized instance, it uses an optimized configuration stack and it provides additional capacity for input and output. That's why it's named as optimized instance. This optimization we have, because of this we have the best performance of your volume, because it minimizes the contention between EBS input output and other traffic. Next, both throughput optimized HDD ST1 and cold HDD, which guarantee performance consistency of 90% of burst throughput 99% of the time in a given year. That means these are such optimized instances that it will give you 99% performance in a complete year. This is non-compliant periods are approximately uniformly distributed. We have targeted that we should require 99% of the expected total throughput each hour. So we have Amazon EBS optimized instances. Like first of all, we require to open a console, launch an instance, choose an AMI, instance type, configure this, and then we require to launch this optimized instances. Then if we require to modify, we have to action instance day, stop, yes stop, then action, we are required to change, and then start. This is how we can change our or we can modify it. Now what are the encryption it follows? Now Amazon EBS encryption, it uses AWS KMS, which is key management service, where we have customer master key, CMK, we are creating encrypted volumes and any snapshots created. That means any snapshot and any volume that is created, we can protect them with the help of customer master key. So what are the type of data that required to be encrypted? Data at rest inside a volume, all moving data and all snapshots that are required to be encrypted. So we have, like, whenever we require, the first time that we create an EBS volume, so we require a default CMK. we can create our own CMK, which gives you more flexibility. We have ability to create, rotate, disable keys, and even we can have, or we can define access controls. We can audit the encryption keys and which are used to protect the data. This feature, that means changing of keys, is supported with all EVS volume types, either general purpose SSDs, provisioned SSDs, throughput optimized SSD called SSD, and even magnetic, which is the standard. Now, whenever we require to create a new EVS volume, we require to have their maximum performance of the movement. Storage blocks on volumes that are restored from snapshots, they must be initialized before you can access the block. So we require to check out the input-output characteristics and monitoring in EVS volume. Now, what are the benchmark? We require to launch EVS optimized instances, create new, we can attach volume, configure, we can install a tool to benchmark input-output performance, we can delete your volumes. Now we can check this, that means how we get required to create these volumes. We will continue in our next class where we can see how to create an EVS volume. Thank you so much.